In this corner, undisputable champion, wig-wearing champion of the world, Bald-Headed Ho, yay! And in this corner is the rest of the world. Ding, ding, ding. She's coming back to regain her title as the world's sassiest wig wearer. Woo! Yeah, you thought I was gone, didn't you? You thought I was gonna return. You thought it was over. You thought AdSense could stop me. Oh no, oh no, she back, she back, she back, she back. Hi, welcome to Bald-Headed Ho, a series where I review wigs. Nothing special to say here, just a series where I review wigs. Thought I was gonna say something clever, didn't you? Nope, not this time. Anyway, today's wig is the A.H. Clara, the A.H. Claire, from Sister Wigs, or also known as Sis, in the color Sombre RTB pink. I think B stands for black, I'm not sure. I really don't know. But either way, I know I've reviewed this wig for two other videos, but I have not reviewed it in this color. I do have other types of wigs on the way, but this is the last wig in this color that I have, so I figure I might as well go ahead and get out the way and just show you what it looks like. Okay, this is not my favorite, so here we go. Okay, everybody, this is Claire. Now, right off the bat, you notice it's a light pink, and this camera is doing it way more justice than it is in person, in my opinion. From what I'm looking through the camera right now, I mean, when you see it, it's going to be HD quality, so you probably will see it in all of its glory. Like, here's a little teeny blonde piece. Now, thinking about it, that B in the b.pink in the card color, that probably stands for blonde, because there is a little bit of blonde in here I'm seeing up underneath. And right off the bat, I'm not crazy about the color. Like, if it was a darker pink, I would have been sold. But it looks just like the stock card, I'm not gonna lie. Except in person, the stock card is a little darker. Yeah, I was kind of deceived, but you know, there's nothing you could do about it. Now, this wig comes with three combs, two in the front and one in the back. It also comes with adjustable straps. The density of the wig is pretty good. It's a really thick wig. I don't know about the percentage because they don't like put that on there. It's mostly on them China sites that charge you a really pretty penny to make the wigs or whatever. Them so-called custom-made wigs. They'll tell you the density, but this one is from, I got it from someplace off the internet, which will not be named, but for so many reasons. But I got it from someplace off the internet, and I don't think you can get them anymore. I don't know where you could find this, but this is actually a rare wig now. You can't find this anymore, and I'm glad I got this. I'm glad I got the colors I got them in. I'm glad I got them in any colors because it's a really pretty wig, the shape, but. I know I bought a lot of crazy colors in the past, but this one seems like it's so dry and ashy colored that it just seemed like I would have to be really bold to have a really nice outfit to wear with this. I mean, this mannequin pulls it off because, you know, she just like thinks she's better than everybody else. She just stuck up and whatever, but you know, not me. I don't know. I can't pull it off like this mannequin can. If you wanted to, if you were crazy enough, you could heat it up to 400 degrees, which would ruin the curl pattern and, you know, everything, but you could heat up to 400 degrees. The cap size is really big, and I was surprised, and because I'm bald, that kind of makes it worse. I think this is made for people that have hair or larger heads, because it's kind of loose. Like, there's a lot of room and space on the tightest setting, because, you know, I always put my wigs on the tightest setting, because, you know, I shave and everything. So yeah, that's just something to be aware of. If you're a bald or if you don't have a lot of hair or a small head, it'd be kind of big on you if you put on a small setting. But if you have hair, there's the combs that give you that extra grip, but I don't have that extra grip, so I have to take what I can get, like maybe like get some tape or something. I'm not using no ghost bond. Good God, no. That would like rip the cap off and stuff like that. And I heard you gotta like have like special. You know, I should know about all this stuff already. But I heard you have to have like a special, like some kind of oil to get to loosen up the ghost bond to pull it off. Seriously, I just been walking around with my wig just on top of my head. Like, I should glue them down before somebody, like, just comes up to me, snatches off, and say, what you gonna do now, ho? What you gonna do now? Like, I'm literally not prepared for that. I mean, I don't really care, but I'm not prepared for it. I mean, I should be prepared for it. And go on a roller coaster, forget about it. No, it's just not gonna happen. All right, as usual, this is the left side of the wig. Obviously, the left side, right side, back side, front side, everything. Okay, so this is the left side of the wig. And as you can see, it's a asymmetrical cut, yeah, and I love asymmetrical cuts. I don't really like straight blunt cuts, not really, but that's what it seems to be in nowadays, that those bobs have those straight blunt cuts. I don't like that. I don't know, and they'd be like $44 and stuff like that, like something that just wants you to like break the bank. Like, I know there's like wigs that are like $300 and $100, but come on, $40 for a wig, no. No, honey, no. But yeah, this is the left side of the wig. It's asymmetrical, and the colors go from black to pinkish blonde to blondish pink. Okay, so right off the bat, this is the right side of the wig, and the curls are a little bit more defined because I didn't rush through with my comb. I try not to mess up the wigs as soon as I get them out of the package, which I haven't worn this wig yet outside. I just pulled out the package. The only one I wore outside was the black one that I showed you guys earlier on my channel, which I don't think got too many views because I didn't speak or anything. These curls are more defined because I didn't rush through them. It seemed like in reality the only wig I'm going to wear is the black one version of this. Not that crazy blonde one. I'm not really too picky about it, but hey, I did whatever. I made a bad decision. So I'm going to show you the back. Let's get there. All right, this is the back side of the wig. And it is not thin by any means. Well, I looked at the oh wow, that one area is real thin. I guess not all wigs are made alike, I suppose. Okay, well, never mind. Well, the black wig is, I swear to God, like these wigs really are thick. They really do be thick. I don't know what's wrong with this one. Did I get a defect or something? I don't know what's wrong with this one. This is not going as planned, like on this side. And what's that? It's droopy. Well, what is that? Can you see that? The cap part is, there's like a dip in there or something. I don't know what that is. I don't know if you can see. I'm not gonna zoom in. That's embarrassing. But yeah, the color scheme goes from black to blondish pink, just like all throughout the wig. There's no dramatic color change from each side or whatever. Okay, so can we just take a minute to address this skin top? That does not look like flesh, people. That's not a skin top. That is the worst skin top I've ever seen, and it's on all three wigs. Some are wider and some are like thinner than others, but it's still a very terrible skin top. It just looks like a small ball space where they didn't sew in hair. I mean, what's up with this? I mean, you should know this is here. I mean, I love the wig, not in this color, of course, but I love the wig, well, I'm pretty sure I made that clear in the video, but look at the skin top, it's awful, and it goes directly in the middle. It's just disgusting. I just don't like it. I just pray there's nobody, like, overhead view, like, angels and stuff, like, looking at it. They'd be like, girl, you do not look snatched on the top. That's the angels be all like, but Yeah, I just had to show you how terrible this skin top is, and I kind of expected better from y'all sister wig and stuff. Wow, I'm sad, my heart hurt. Okay, so this video is going on way too long. It's about like 9 minutes almost, so I'm gonna have to cut it, cut it long because it's not short. What do I say? No, let me stop, I'll stop. But yeah, guys, thanks for tuning in every time I make a video. You know my real supporters, I mean, sometimes I have like one view. I see you one view, unless that's me. I'm not really sure. Thank you for watching my videos. I promise the old bald head hole will return with the old formula. I was just trying something new just to see if I get a different view count or something like that. I promise that this formula will return. I'll do the same, the old stuff I used to do and stuff like that. like show you the wig, actually tell you how many combs and adjustable straps are in there. Like, it's better to tell you the information and just read it, but not to bore you, but just telling you that the undefeated champ is back. Yeah, the undefeated wig wearer champ is back. Woo! Power up to the bald head whole nation. Woo!